Hello everyone, I am Dr. Madhav Raite from STEM Medica India. Our center providing stem cell therapy for knee cartilage regeneration. So the patient who is not willing for knee replacement surgery, they can try and choose this type of treatment. This is completely natural, no surgery required. So today we are talking about role of stem cell, using of stem cell, implication of stem cell in case of knee cartilage regeneration or any bone joint cartilage regeneration. So now we are starting the session. First of all, what is cartilage? Cartilage is a flexible connective tissue found mainly in joints. Produce of specialized cells called chondrocytes, which originate from mesenchymal stem cells. When damaged, cartilage repairs very slowly. Many people suffer from diseases that affect the cartilage, such as osteoarthritis, osteochondritis, and relapsing polychondritis. Here is the figure which showing how mesenchymal stem cells could be differentiated into osteoblast, adipocytes, and chondrocytes. So it was proved in a preclinical model, animal model, and even in human volunteer also. In vivo and in vitro, that mesenchymal stem cells would be differentiated into osteoblast, adipocyte, and chondrocytes. So this is the evolution of osteoarthritis here above. So this is the joint, bone, cartilage, and thinning of cartilage. See, in this second picture we are seeing the redness, right, and the gap which already decreases. In third picture you can see the contour of end of bone is completely destroyed, and in these pictures, see, in this slide we are seeing these are contour sites in lacunae. This is the matrix containing elastic fibers, and this is ear pinna cartilage. History of cartilage repair. In 1924, a Russian morphologist Alexander Maximov finds a precursor cell in mesenchyme that differentiates into different cells. Later on in 1963, Dr. McCulloch and Dr. Till find self-renewing cells in mice bone marrow. In 1917, Dr. Fredenstein finds the potential for multipotent marrow cells to reproduce. 1984, Swedish researcher use autologous chondrocyte to repair a rabbit's damaged patella, calling the procedure autologous chondrocyte implantation. In 1995, the ACI procedure, that is autologous chondrocyte implantation, become available for human use. In 2000, current research for the use of mesenchymal stem cells to be used for damaged cartilage. Current cartilage repair technology. What we have right now in a cartilage repair? First, is a marrow stimulation. In this procedure, the damaged cartilage is drilled out of a joint until doctors reach bone. The bone is then perforated, forming a blood clot at the joint, which will eventually produce fibrocartilage. Second procedure is osteochondral autografts. The damaged cartilage is taken from the joint and healthy cartilage from another area replaces it. The damaged cartilage is then put into the area where the healthy cartilage was taken. Third one is autologous chondrocyte implantation. Small amount of healthy cartilage is taken from a joint and the chondrocytes are isolated and grown in vitro until there is enough cartilage to be implanted. Here is the procedure. The damaged cartilage is taken out and the healthy cartilage was implanted. That is the one procedure. Secondly, the small part of cartilage biopsy was taken, then chondrocyte was cultured in a vitro in a lab, and then again this chondrocyte transplanted into affected joint. Mesenchymal stem cell transplantation. Mesenchymal cells taken from adipose tissue, bone marrow or embryonic connective tissue. These cells are then cultured and made to reproduce, and once there is enough to replace the cartilage, it is implanted into the joint with a growth factor to continue growth as well as scaffold to promote the shape of the cartilage. Either while being cultured or after implantation, a signal is introduced to the mesenchymal cell to differentiate into cartilage. Mesenchymal stem cell transplantation. This procedure has been mainly tested on animal subjects such as rats and goats. Recently, a couple cases have been successful in repairing menisci in patients with damaged knee cartilage. The procedure still has many years until it is used in the medical field. But in a current scenario, there are a lot of clinics, lot of clinical trials going on, and the outcome is very promising. I don't think so it will take more than a couple of years to be on mainstream. So we can use a mesenchymal stem cell as a one strong alternative to knee replacement surgery. Limitations. The acquiring of mesenchymal stem cells for the procedure, we can't say it is a limitation, because it's the source of mesenchymal cells are various and it easily available. In case of adult stem cells or adult source, we have bone marrow, adipose tissue, that is in ample number. Adipose tissue is the viable and easily available source also. Second one is hasn't been tested on humans in a large scale yet. That is true. Cartilage form may still not work as effectively. That is partial true, we can say, because there are a lot of patients who got treated by stem cell, mesenchymal cells. They're performing well. They doesn't have any complaint or pain, anything. And their diagnostic test also, like radiological test, X-ray, MRI, that shows good cartilage regeneration. When procedure is available, it will likely be expensive. This stem cell transplantation is expensive one. Future use in the medical field will become the main procedure in cartilage repair. Easier way to attain the mesenchymal stem cells, decrease in the cost of the procedure. That's it. Thank you.